In this lesson, we will discuss the fluid property called vapor pressure. Vapor pressure, which is denoted as PV, is a measure of a fluid's volatility. Imagine a sealed box that contains a pure liquid vapor mixture, such as water. Now we remove all of the vapor. At that moment in time, there'll be a net flux of molecules evaporating from the surface. Some of these molecules will later return to the liquid, and eventually an equilibrium will be established between the rate molecules evaporate from the liquid surface and the rate molecules return back to the liquid. The pressure caused by the evaporated molecules colliding with the liquid surface at equilibrium is the vapor pressure. The vapor pressure is an important property in thermodynamics as well. However, in thermodynamics, the vapor pressure is usually called the saturation pressure and often denoted by Psat. The vapor pressure is a strong function of temperature. For example, for water at 20 degrees Celsius, the vapor pressure is 2.3 times 10 to the 3 pascals. If water is heated to 100 degrees Celsius, the vapor pressure increases to 1 atmosphere, or 1.013 times 10 to the 5 pascals. If the local pressure falls below the vapor pressure, the liquid will spontaneously form vapor bubbles in a process called boiling. If you place a pot of water at 20 degrees into a vacuum chamber and remove air from the chamber, the pot of water will start boiling when the pressure drops below 2300 pascals. In enclosed systems, such as pipes and pumps, we must be careful to avoid creating regions where the local pressure drops below the vapor pressure. If this occurs, vapor bubbles can spontaneously form in the liquid, then be transported to a region of higher pressure where they collapse violently in a process called cavitation. Cavitation creates pressure waves that can damage devices over time.